Yo, but on a serious note, congrats to the Raptors for winning the NBA championship finally. You know, it was probably back in 60s, 70s when my Wizards won their first one. But, you know, that was back in them days where, you know, some of y'all wasn't born. So I'm glad y'all finally won.
When they was the Bullets?
Don't matter.
So the Wizards have never won?
Nah.
So shut the fuck up.
Okay, MJ. Okay, we have Mike.
Hey, fun fact, the last team that swept the Raptors in the finals, I mean, in the playoffs was who?
I'm kids. I'm kids.
Is that a fact or are you just making that shit up?
All I know is we swept their ass in 2015. Fuck you talking about when we had Captain Hall and we had Big B Bill.
Alright, that doesn't matter, bro.
I know
we didn't even win.
And y'all, they probably beat y'all ass within the last 3 years. But yo, on a serious note, we got Drake, two tracks. You got Omerta, and what's the other one? May God.
It's called Money in the Grave. I don't know
Money
what
in the Grave.
May God bless you, boy.
It was something about like a grace or something. Money in the Grave.
Money in the Grave. You look like a your head look like a tombstone, boy.
What do you look like right now? You look like you work at like the FYE, boy, where they got all the movies and you had to walk around with a movie shirt. They made you walk around with a movie shirt. You in there helping everybody find the old classics, boy.
Look at the artwork, bro. The trophy.
Spotlight on trophy.
With he got signature. His signature. You didn't play. I'm not going to lie, though. I've enjoyed the Drake post interviews. And
I feel like when people be like, Drake acting like he playing, Drake acting like he one of the players, they line him up for that. I'm going to give a shout out to all the Milwaukee fans. But imagine you from Milwaukee. They go to the finals. And in the game, you on the floor, you kind of like talking shit. But hey, look, got a camera on you. So you like, all right, bet. They think I'm Mr. Milwaukee. Then look, after the finals, they coming up to you like, yo, what do you think? What do you think? You'll be like, I'm on my mind fucking level right now. We what? You going to do the same thing, bro.
My only argument for that is that y'all would do the same thing if y'all had access and status the same way Drake does in his city with that team. Don't worry, y'all can see me at the Wizards game, floor seats. What you talking?
Who?
You and who else, boy?
Me and Glizzy. Or me and Wall. Who will beat your ass up because he gangbang Wall. Gang sign John Wall.
This nigga John Wall be at Rose Bar with regular ass junks.
Nigga junks that I can get.
Be up there with the New Balance and Hugo fit.
With a nappy fro. What's good with y'all? We about to head over to the roof. Rest.
Hey, can we start the song? Like, you chilling. Like, come on. You really chilling.
We just did artwork.
Start the song. Waited all day for this shit. Yeah.
Look at my history. I'm trying to see what's different from that guy and the richer me. A lot of relax on my other niggas is overreacting. That's how we continue down the path of Jordan.
All right. That was a lot that we just...
A whole lot.
Didn't address.
Do we have to say a bunch of it? Because I'm getting it. I like the Bron reference. I like the Tina Marie. I like I'm with it so far. Mm-hmm. But if y'all need that breakdown,
hit you out of nowhere like epiphany.
Fire.
Hit you out of nowhere like
epiphany. You know how I just had an epiphany?
Ah.
Yeah. You know what?
Testing me, gonna have my niggas testing machinery. This the thing. I believe everything Drake said after Ye was bitch.
If my family get hurt, it's Drake. If anybody hurt my family, it's Drake.
You think that's serious, but I felt like that was like,
ever
damn.
Ever since I heard Mom Ties,
I'd be like, all right, bet. Drake got his.
Nah, we gotta be sensitive on Kanye. Like, Kanye be going through a lot. And if you're going through a lot mentally, and you got a nigga that's like, yo, come outside,
crap,
nigga.
Down the block.
You listening to a song a different way. You like, everybody go inside.
Like, yeah, Drake even say something. What'd he say? Mob stories, mob ties, old families, ethics and values, mob traditions, old-fashioned monopoly action. Ronnie Bryan of Brentwood, like he still live in Akron.
A lot of pain, a lot of passion, a lot of relax for my other niggas is overreacting.
It's about him and LeBron.
That's how we continue down the path of Jordan and Jackson.
Think about it. He said, a lot of pain, a lot of passion, a lot of relax while other niggas overreacting. That's how we continue down the path of Jordan and Jackson. Michael Jordan and Michael Jackson.
Oh, damn.
About him and Bron.
A lot of overreacting, my niggas is really relaxing.
Whatever he said.
I'm thinking he was talking about, I don't know why I didn't think Michael Jackson. I thought Phil Jackson.
Yes.
I'm thinking about Phil, but yours works though. And yours is probably what he meant. Jordan and Jackson, but I also was thinking we keep traveling down the path of Jordan and Jackson, like we keep winning championships, me and Bron. Even if it's true,
it's a double entendre.
Yeah, I bet.
Because but Jordan and Jackson, like you going down the Michael Jordan path, I'm going down the Michael Jackson.
So yeah, my nigga, keep up.
Last year niggas really feel like they rolled on me. Last year niggas got hot cause they told on me.
Push your teeth. Told niggas that he had a baby mother.
Right.
Got hot. We ain't gonna say he got hot because his album was one of the best of last year. But very true. Definitely got a spike in numbers from that. Yes.
I'm buying a building at every door that closed on me. Yeah.
I love that, bro. I'm buying the building of every door that closed on me. It should be everybody's move for 2019 to 2020.
Everybody's move, period. Because you ain't gonna get it in 2019.
And it's not.
You just now thinking about that?
And that's really not easy.
That can't be your goal for 2019, but definitely your life goal.
Yeah, okay, yeah. Life goals.
Champagne popper, the love doctor. Your baby mother call me when she lonely. Me, Benihana is pigeon food. It's not a forgiving mood.
To me, Benihana is pigeon food. The first time I went to Benihana, I was like, bet we in Benihana.
I don't like when niggas do that,
dog. I was doing something.
I don't like when niggas do that, dog.
To me, that's the equivalent of when they be like, you riding in your Honda.
Okay, I get it if he talking shit, but damn, though.
That basically lets you know, when you get to a certain level, bro, you do look at places like Benihana like, all right, whatever.
Yeah.
Are you catching the Biggie rap? The Biggie flow?
I caught the Biggie flow, yeah. But
like,
I was
like, forever grateful, forever thankful. Diamond necklace, but she wears it on her ankle. The bitch is trendy.
It's a Biggie.
Yeah,
it's like a Biggie flow.
I fucked with that, too.
Keeping my connection strictly physical. Everyone that's married is miserable.
Somebody had to say it, right?
Everybody that's married is miserable.
That's not true, though. Look at Megan Good and her husband. That shit, if I was married to Megan Good, I wouldn't be miserable.
I know you didn't just bring.
I don't think any couple.
Will Smith and Jada ain't miserable.
You won't know that.
Will Smith and Jada not a couple, though.
Yeah.
That's the fuck they are.
They're on a different level, bro. They're on a different level. They look at their relationship way different than a lot of other people.
Keeping my connection strictly physical. Everyone that's married is miserable. I know that's not a lifestyle that I can give into.
Yeah, but that's also Drake.
That's also some whack shit too.
But my thing is, when you Drake, you probably don't have time for a marriage. Because a Drake marriage and a us or any random person getting married, that's two different things. So I'm gonna give him the benefit of the doubt on that. How do you think he's gonna name all the mainstream places to go?
But he said never go to the same places they go.
Send them to Lagos or Turks and Caicos, Barbados, Trinidad, and Tobago. Never go the same places they go.
Step in a room in October gets a lot closer.
October's very young. I mean, if I step in a room, that, but also, Halloween, it's a scary sight.
Double entendre.
I wish that I was playing a sport where we were getting rings. I wouldn't have space on either hand for anything, meaning I would have 10 rings.
Basically, what he's saying is I would eventually get to that point.
I wouldn't have space on my hands for anything.
Death to a coward and a traitor,
that's just in my nature. Meaning, it is what it is, and I got ties.
I don't think Drake would really body somebody, but then again,
of course he wouldn't.
He got money. Somebody.
Yeah. That was definitely some, what would you call it? Would you call that diplomatic immunity, Drake?
I feel like it's the track like that we're going to get from Drake every year.
Did you say we was going to get a track like this?
Or did you say we was going to get more of a hype track?
Shout out to everybody on Twitter that said we about to get like a diplomatic immunity Drake. Because people was like, nah, we probably would get like a, I got a really big tip, we got some really big range Drake. We didn't know what we was going to get out of
that track. Well, let me say this. I knew for a fact both of these songs, probably neither of these songs, but I knew for a fact these songs didn't have anything to do with the Raptors winning.
I thought maybe Omerta might have some wordplay like, yo, we did it.
I knew that one of these songs would be one where he was rapping. And I knew that this next one probably going to be the song for the radio, bro. Remember he did Diplomatic Immunity and God's Plan.
Yes.
God's Plan, play right. The radio, but this is, let me say what I got to say.
But this other one might be the one. If anybody doesn't know what Omerta is, it's more so like a code of silence about criminal activity. You know, people say Omerta the code, it's a mafia term.
And this is our first time hearing it, so let me say this. We probably missed a bunch of the short disses, the disses you had to kind of go and research and figure out.
Yeah.
So
don't kill us about it, please.
Don't kill us about that, but you know what? For me, I felt like this is one of the first songs where Drake didn't really have too much.
It wasn't like Sandra's Rose.
Yeah, like he didn't have too much drama in this one. It's just straight wordplay. Like I'm on a different level than all of y'all. Yeah. For real, for real.
Last time we got tired of women that may tag me in airing my dirty laundry and the Arada damn trip.
Yeah, I think it was more, but guess what? We didn't catch that. We didn't catch that A-Rod damn tripping on review, so guess what?
Oh,
we probably missed a bunch of shit.
Whatever. Hey, look, fuck it.
Y'all didn't know that he was rhyming the exact same.
Kudos to you, Cookie.
Let me just say this. Rick Ross and Drake have never, ever put out a song that was not good. I mean, not saying that they don't have L's that they've taken on their own, but like when it's a Drake featuring Rick Ross or Rick Ross featuring Drake, it's always a W. So far. You know who that is?
Push Pause. Yeah.
Lil CeCe was fine from what I seen. Yeah, I used to follow her for a minute. Then I don't follow her.
Shout out to her for the beat.
I got two phones, one need a charge. They twins, I can tell they ain't apart.
Why is the twin lines always about whether you can tell them apart?
I don't know. I guess it's cool for niggas that ain't twins. But let me tell you something. As a twin, all your twin jokes and lines ain't cool.
I got hoes that I'm keeping in the dark. You should fuck with that, right? Don't say that like I got hoes that I'm keeping in the dark. I have no hoes in the dark. Fuck is wrong with this nigga?
Oh, yeah, I got you. Yeah, you right. He don't.
Because now you try to make it seem like I do. I really don't.
Oh, yeah, you right.
Shut your ass up, nigga.
Damn. Look, you realize? Look, he about to. Look.
Shit. If y'all don't think so, that some of y'all fellas are in the dark?
Yeah, hell yeah.
Women definitely got some men in the dark.
Mm-hmm.
All of us sitting there with the light off.
Yep.
In the next life, I'm trying to stay paid. When I die, I put my money in. Couple figures to the score with the left. She fucking nigga, then she on to the next. You could DM my account. My DM six figures and I'm counting.
I thought it was alright.
That joint was the first time Rick Ross and Drake got together and it was really some mid.
It didn't have like a, damn, I want to listen to this again. That really sounded like a throwaway track.
I don't think it was bad. I like when I die, I put my money in the grave. Like, I'm taking all of my shit with me. I get it.
I don't like that.
Why the hell you burying all that money?
Give it away.
But you know that's one of the sayings. You can't take that money with you when you go.
How about the Drake verse?
I guess when I die, I put my money in the grave.
Exactly. The Drake verse was aight. The Rick Ross verse was okay. It wasn't crazy. Everything was okay about money in the grave. It was like, I like how he said with the trap jumping like Zion when I rebound it. Fuck with that.
That's cool.
But that was alright.
I felt like it wasn't a song that I wanted to go back and listen to for the sound. Like it wasn't something that made me say, alright, bet I'm gonna play this in the whip.
What I'm thinking about is the fact that these niggas' pens are much better than what they just delivered together. I know you probably don't want to play it on here, but if we go back and listen to Lord Knows.
Oh, okay, yeah, I feel you.
And play that and listen to, I feel like the Ross you would get on a Lord Knows project track is different from the release like this.
I mean, yeah, but think about Aston Martin Music.
But then you gotta think about this though. I heard it's rumored that Drake ain't dropping this shit. I heard this is what we get for real, for real. Little singles, but I heard that they said Drake ain't dropping at least for the summer, I mean. Maybe in the fall. I don't know. I don't think we should take this song too serious like this is the single from the album.
I guess you're right then.
You know what I mean? We're not going to take it too serious like this is the
album.
All
I know
is when I think about like Made, is it Made Niggas or Made Men? Remember that Made Niggas joint they did with DJ Khaled?
I don't remember, bro.
Oh, I remember I'm On One. It's so many tracks with them two that I wanted this to be another one of those, and it's not.
I feel you.
Which is fine.
Hey, put your thoughts in the comments. There's going to be a poll right here. Let us know how you felt about the project.
Well, not the project, but the two songs. Oh, Murder, Money in the Grave. Shout out to that girl CC for producing that last track and whoever produced the first track. The last two song thing he did, Scary Hours, actually was way better than this.
Yeah, like I just
we got
like
God's Plan and Diplomatic Immunity where he went off on Diplomatic Immunity and then gave the song of the summer for God's Plan. Hey, look, follow us on the socials. They're going to be right down here. If you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button.
Sir.
If you already been here, just make sure you got the notification bell on.
Yes, sir. Yeah, check out the merch. It's going to be in the link in the description down below. Mallory Bros merch. Go get you something nice.
Nigga didn't even let me finish the...
Fuck it.
Because you won't let me. You won't let me. Check out the Mallory Bros merch in the description box. Go and check it out. Get you something nice. By this time, you probably hear Bruce Wayne. I know what that means, dog. Like, comment, share, subscribe. Bruce Wayne. Oh, no.